In this demo, we'll take a look at AARI Web. Specifically, we'll be looking at a financial services use case around the proof of funds letter generation process. So for our backstory, there is a financial services organization called Eagle One Financial. Their customer service agents are frequently asked to generate proof of funds letters to send customers in support of loan applications. So we've all done these in applying for mortgages and applying for auto loans. You have to provide some evidence of proof of funds so that they know that you're good for the money. The current state is that customer support agents log in to multiple systems to get investment and savings account details for the customer proof of funds letter. The account details are manually entered into a Word document, and we know that when this happens, sometimes agents are using screenshots to show the amount of funds that the particular customer has, while others are hand typing the data as they see it in the form, while others are just copying and pasting directly from the investment management and savings account applications and pasting that into the form. Needless to say, it's a non-standardized template that goes out. It's a non-standardized letter that ends up getting sent to the customer. The email is then sent with that non-standard language and the attachment in non-standard formatting. So we've got an issue of A, there's a lot of legwork that has to be done for this, and B, we've got varying degrees of quality of the actual output that is being sent to the customers. The target state is that a customer support agent will log into AARI Web and enter the customer ID. At that point, a unattended bot would be kicked off to fetch all of the customer account details from the multiple systems and generate that standard letter in a standardized format using a template. So in this case, the bot is going to log into the financial services application. The bot is going to call the APIs to get the bank and savings information. And then the bot is also going to build and generate that letter. The customer support agent would then visually verify all of the data that was retrieved for the customer using AARI Web before submitting that letter for mailing. The bot would then email the letter to the customer with a standardized email template to make sure that all the language is consistent in both the email and in the included attached proof of funds letter. So in this process, not only would we be standardizing the process to clean up the language, make sure that our outgoing proof of funds letters always look the exact same, but we'll also be speeding up the process so that our customer support agents are able to pay more attention on the phone and not have to go fetch all of these details manually. Let's take a look at this in action. The solution developed to meet this use case is actually made up of three components. First, there's the process. And the process is what ties together the forms and the bots that are being used to actually generate this human and bot collaboration process. The next component is a form itself, and a form is where a human is actually getting involved to send information to a bot and also to review information that the bot may have fetched and sent back to the human for manual review. The third component is the bot itself, and again, we want to think of bots as rule-based task automation, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're taking some kind of input, in this case, from a human that's being kicked off as a part of this process. They're going and doing some kind of research, and in this case, doing some sort of letter generation, and then coming back to the process with the output of what the bot has generated, and that includes some data that it's done for research, as well as a generated letter. Now, a user who is using AARI wouldn't necessarily see this part of things. The user process starts on the actual AARI page. So here we are on that AARI page, and this is where a user can actually start to create a new request which can invoke that bot. So I'm going to click on this Create Request button up here. We can see that one process has been assigned for this particular agent that's logged in. And here it is available. So I'm going to click on that. And it's going to show me a form. And that form is going to ask for some level of detail. This case is only one field, but there could be three or four or 10, however it's designed. In this case, our process is, again, to generate that proof of funds letter. And so what we're going to start with is entering the customer's ID into this form. So I'm going to fill in a sample customer ID and hit submit. And now we've started that AARI process. And when we started that process, we've created a request. And see, we have a request ID right up here. Now, nothing is happening on the actual agent's machine. But What has happened on the back end is that an unattended bot runner has now been invoked. It's been sent the details for this request, and the unattended bot runner has now just come back with the details of that research. So it grabbed that 8709 that was sent in, and then it did the research to figure out what's that customer's name, what's their email address, what's their total account value, what are their account IDs across multiple applications, what are their account types that we have at this institution, and then where was that letter that was generated for sending out to that customer. Now, I know that all went really, really quick. I showed in kind of a picture-in-picture exactly what that bot was doing so you could see it. But again, normally that would not show up for an agent. That's only there for the purposes of illustration. Now, the bot is asking, do you want to actually send this email with those details or do you want to cancel? Obviously, I could go here and try to review those details if I wanted to or review that letter. I'm going to choose to send this. I'm going to send it to myself so I can see the results. I'll fill that in and hit send. Again, that's going to invoke that unattended bot runner. So we'll show picture in picture again, but this one doesn't actually bring up any applications. There's nothing exciting to see here. This is simply just invoking the send of an email. Here we can see that request is closed. And here we have the email that was sent by the bot. So it says, dear, and we have the full customer's name here. Please find the requested proof of funds verification letter attached. It's been our pleasure to serve you here at Eagle One Financial. And so we've got a really standardized email. We've got standard language there. We've got a standard format for the way that's going to be sent out. And then we also have this attachment. And if we look at the attachment, notice that again, it's following a template. It's following a very standardized process. We've got proper heading and footer on it that represent the brand. And then we've got information like the date. We've filled in all of the appropriate account numbers here. We've filled in all of the appropriate account types. We've also filled in their total balance across accounts. And we've done the same thing down here where we've filled in their name into the letter itself, as well as their total account balance. So I know I keep saying we in this process, but the reality is the bot is the one that generated this entire letter. The bot's the one that did all of the research to find the details for the letter. And the bot's also the one that actually sent this letter out to our customer. So in this way, we've ensured that we've got a really standardized template for the way that we're sending out these communications. We can make sure that they look really professional. We can make sure that they adhere to all of our legal guidelines. And we can make sure that our customers are seeing a really standardized, high quality product coming out of our customer service. So in closing, let's look at how Eagle One Financial benefits in this situation. First, they have democratized engagement with bots across the organization, right? So customer service agents can quickly invoke bots. We can have that happening from the front office. We can also have that coming from the back office. Productivity improvements with available automation assistance at the click of a button. So again, these users can invoke bots. Those bots can run on unattended bot runners. There's also AARI Desktop that allows for automation as attended use cases. But in this case, we were looking at a situation where an unattended bot runner was doing all of that work. It would then come back to the operator and let them know, hey, this task is done. Here's some information that I found. A more engaged customer service agent. So again, if I don't have to do all that lookup on my own, if I'm not having to do that research while I'm on the phone with a customer, I can engage better with the customer. I can talk to them. I can listen. I can make sure that I'm talking to them in a way that makes them feel respected and that they know that I'm giving them my full attention. And finally, all of this leads to an improved customer experience. Not only is their experience calling into the call center better, but their experience with the outcome and the resulting product is better as well, because they're getting a standardized email with standard language and they're getting a nice looking template that has the proof of funds letter that they had requested. Hopefully you found this AARI demo helpful. If you have any additional questions, don't hesitate to reach out to your account manager or try out AARI on Community Edition. Go be great.